This morning with us on this 4th of July weekend, and we're asking that the Lord will bless us in a special way on this morning. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you. We're grateful. We're humble that a God like you would love us so unconditionally. For Lord, while we were yet sinners, you died for the sins of humanity. Now, Lord, help us understand that as we serve you, we partner with divine initiative. God, we thank you that you have allowed us to be your sons and daughters. And so when we serve you, God, we are bringing you glory and blessing the faith community. Help us understand, God, that all that we do, all that we are, belongs to you. And God, let us know that our serving, our loving, our living is not in vain. That we are people of impact and labor to be people of impact for your divine plan. We thank you, Lord. We love you. For it's in Jesus Christ's name we do pray. Amen and amen. Our scripture today is found in Joshua chapter 2, verse 1. Joshua chapter 2, verse 1. Listen to the word of the Lord, beloved. Then Joshua secretly sent out two spies from the Israelite camp at Achaia Grove. He instructed them, scout out the land on the other side of the Jordan River, especially around Jericho. We want to talk about people of impact. People of impact. In our biblical case study today, we find a great source of spiritual insight, information, and inspiration. The text reveals two unsung heroes unnamed in our text. Beloved, these brothers maneuver behind the scenes undetected by the Canaanites to do some military reconnaissance. Their intel proves to be vital for capturing the city of Jericho. Although their contributions were great, their identity remains unknown. We are on a need-to-know basis in the text. We're given their roles and capabilities and a commissioning from their leader, Joshua. Couple of things that leap out to me that are worth mentioning today. These brothers must have been trustworthy because they are given a task that not everyone knows about. And secondly, Joshua vouches for their ability. After all, he personally handpicks and selects them and then sends them out on a secret mission. Consequently, the city of Jericho is not actually captured until chapters 6 and 7. However, chapters 1 and 2 sets the tone for what will happen in the life of Israel. Beloved, if one moves too quickly through verse 1 of chapter 2, we'll miss vital information on how God partners with humanity to carry out his divine will. What are you trying to say, Pastor Brantley? We as Christians can participate by realizing every intricate part of God's plan is essential. Brothers and sisters, we are extensions of his love, his grace, his service to humanity. And whatever service we provide in the overall scheme of bringing people to God is important. After all that we have should belong to God. Unfortunately, more times than not, people are drawn to biblical characters with great storylines who accomplish supernatural feats in the name of the Lord. Even in this 21st century of ministry today, leaders are drawn, seem to service attached to positions and titles rather than a specific function or role. What are you trying to say, Pastor Brantley? I'm glad you asked. There's a danger of being sucked into a recognition-based service in ministry. Don't get me wrong, everyone wants to be valued and deserves to be valued for what they bring to the faith community. However, when recognition becomes the primary motivation behind our service to God and community, that kind of service can be toxic and become a ticking time bomb. Sometimes the applause never comes. Sometimes the thank yous don't come as often as you think they should. And then we can begin to resent the service we render on behalf of God and people, which becomes quite alarming because we serve a sovereign God who on one hand is creator and sustainer of all. However, he has chosen to seemingly limit his power to partner with human initiative. And so, beloved, a paradox exists. God chooses to partner with humanity who are agents of free will and choice. Hoffman Jr. puts it like this: some of the most gifted and talented and prominent people use their resources selfishly for themselves and actually become debilitated by their gifts. Then God has to look elsewhere for help and ends up using people of more modest talents and even questionable reputations. What Hoffman Jr. is saying to us, beloved, If the although God desires to partner with all of us to accomplish his will, he will use those who want to serve and not have to serve based on what's in it for them. For in our text this morning, it reveals a powerful ministry for people of impact that are not always mentioned by name, but choose to partner with God with great impact. As Joshua sends out these two spies into the land of Canaan to explore the territory, he remembers his own experiences nearly 40 years ago with Moses, as he was a participant in an intelligence mission in Numbers chapter 13. He, along with 11 other spies representing each tribe of Israel, were to explore and provide intel on the land that God had promised them. However, only two spies out of the 10 spies brought back intel that was useful to inspire vision, strength, and courage about conquering the land of Canaan. This time, Joshua would not take a chance on such a divine mission on names of important people or tribal prestige or position, which is good news for many of us who feel we have nothing to offer because we lack the right family name or the right pedigree. Perhaps we feel that we've been overlooked or cast aside because the text brings us hope today. And the first thing this text reveals to us today about people of impact is that they make themselves available to God. People of impact make themselves available to God. Although these two spies' names are never mentioned, they made themselves available to be used by God and Joshua. It's right there in the text. Then Joshua secretly sent out two spies from the Israelite camp at Achaia Grove. Even though we don't know their names, beloved, when Joshua called their number, they answered the call to service. My God, will you answer the call of service? So the question is this, for us who feel insignificant and who don't hold titles, are we available for service in this busy, fast-paced life of convenience and leisure and ministry? Are we available? Many of us have ability, but we lack the desire and the follow-through that commitment demands for ministry. Jesus said, if any man will come after me, let them deny themselves, take up their cross daily, and follow me. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all of these other things will be added unto you. The second thing people of impact do is that they have a willingness to serve. They have a willingness to serve. What should we see in this text is two spies whose names that are never mentioned, they have a willingness to serve. It's implied in the text. He, meaning Joshua, instructed them, scout out the land on the other side of the Jordan River, especially around Jericho. We can never underplay the role of a committed person of impact that partners with God. Because God takes what looks insignificant and makes them significant. He will take a person without position or prestige and make them a pivotal plan of his work. These unnamed gentlemen had extraordinary responsibility of supplying information that God could use and Israel could use at their advantage on the battlefield that would lead to victory and defeat of the Canaanites. These people were people of impact, and God uses them for his divine purpose. The third thing of impact, people of impact do is that they provide necessary services to God. These two men were providing a necessary service for God and the whole united nation of Israel. God uses them to advance his divine agenda of bringing them closer to a homeland for the children of Israel. Now, this may not mean much to you, but this means a whole lot to me. We must realize that if we're available to God, regardless of who we are or where we are in life's journey, God can use what we have to serve his divine plan and his divine will. The old folk put it like this, there is no secret what God can do. What he's done for others, he'll do the same for you. And just perhaps there might be a few people here today who feel that their contribution doesn't matter because nobody knows your name. Let me suggest that you are exactly who God is looking for, because God has a way of making the insignificant significant and the forgotten the main attraction, just to prove that the power is not in human initiative alone, but through the power of a divine God. For the Bible declares, if God be for us, who can be against us? Who God blesses, no man can curse. Who God curses, no man can bless. Can I call a few more case studies of those whose names were never mentioned in the Bible, but they have been used by God, touched by God, inspired by God, and blessed by God for God's glory and to be people of impact. In Exodus chapter 2, verses 1 through 10, there's an unnamed Egyptian princess, daughter of an unnamed Egyptian pharaoh, who becomes a Hebrew slave child foster mother. This princess named that baby Moses, saying, I drew him out of the water. The baby's name indicates that the princess chose to acknowledge the baby's heritage and knew a bit about Hebrew herself. For the name Moses is related to the root word in Hebrew, meaning I drew him out. She is a deliverer to the one who delivers God's people from slavery some 80 years later. She's a woman of impact, a person of impact. There was a Canaanite woman from Tyre of Sidon found in Matthew chapter 15, verse 20 through 28. No name for this Canaanite woman is mentioned, but she comes to Jesus hoping to get her daughter healed. Jesus' disciples dismiss her, and Jesus insults her, but her persistence and resilience move the heart of Jesus, and Jesus heals her daughter. She's a woman of impact. The woman with the issue of blood, her name is never mentioned, just her personal issue and her situation. But she presses through the crowd to get to Jesus and touches the hem of his garment. Jesus said, someone touched me, the virtue left my body. Jesus said, thy faith has made you whole. There's a Samaritan woman at the well. Her name is never mentioned, but when she encounters Jesus, she accepts Jesus as the living water. And through her witness, her whole community comes to know Jesus as Savior. There's a centurion soldier who's not mentioned by name, but had a sick servant at a home, and he wanted Jesus to heal him, but he felt unworthy of Jesus coming to his home. So this unnamed centurion soldier said, Lord, if you just speak the word, I know he will be healed. Jesus marveled at that faith, and he said, I've never seen faith like that before in the house of Israel. There was a leper who came to Jesus without a name, came back to Jesus after Jesus healed him. He said, thank you. And listen, beloved, we ought to tell the Lord thank you today, for he's been good to us. He's been brought us from a mighty long way. And listen, even though all of these people's names are never mentioned in the Bible, they are not recognized by name, but they're recognized by the service they do. There's another name that's above every name, that the knee shall bow. And that name is Jesus. He came and he died for the sins of humanity. They put him in a borrowed tomb. They put nails in his hands. He died on Friday. Went down in a burial tomb. But early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hands. Beloved, don't worry about the challenges of service. Don't worry about who doesn't know your name. Don't worry about who gets the credit. After all, it all belongs to God for his kingdom agenda, for his glory, for his honor, that we become people of impact to bless other people. But Jesus said, if I be lifted up from the earth, that I'll draw all men and women unto God. And after all, beloved, that is our job. Our job is to bring people to God so that he can deliver them, so that he can heal them, so that he can save them. Beloved, we love you today. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. Maybe there's someone here today that does not know the Lord. And you want to be a person of impact. You want to be someone that blesses other people. Let me suggest to you, the best way you can get to do that is by knowing who God is. And by knowing who God is, you have the compassion, the empathy, the sympathy, the humility that God demands. And so we want to invite you today to find Jesus as your, discover Jesus as your Savior. And so if you're out there today and you don't know who he is, we want to extend this invitation of discipleship. Let us pray with you this morning. Gracious God, I pray for those who are listening today who do not know who you are, who may not know who you are, feels that their service is insignificant, feels like they don't matter because their name is not known by the masses or they don't have a position or title. God, I come and I touch and agree with them and I say, Lord, touch them right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Let them know that they are wonderfully made in the image of God. And for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, whosoever believeth in them shall not perish, but have everlasting life. God, we ask that you will move on their hearts and let them understand that all they have to do is confess and believe that you died for their sins and that you rose on the third day with all power in your hands. And if they believe that, they shall be saved. They will be saved. We thank you right now. For it's in Jesus the Christ's name we do pray. Amen. Beloved, I want to hear from you. You are a person of impact and will continue to be people of impact. If you want to be a part of our St. Matthew Church family, all you got to do is just call 744-418. And someone will get with you and you'll get your information and I will return your call personally. You can also reach me at revcbrantley@gmail.com. That's revcbrantley@gmail.com. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. Great is God.